So how to aim your recurve bow. Before we get started, I want to say that aiming is not as important as you think. For recurve, the priority is on movement and doing the correct shot instead of aiming too much. So too many people focus on getting the best aim they can, keeping the sight on the middle, and while they're keeping the sight on the middle, just doing kind of the shot as well as they can within that. That's the wrong way around to do it. What you need to do is do your best shot with your best movement and your best overall shot process, and within that, get whatever best aim you can within this good shot. That's the correct way around to do it. It will mean that your sight is more wobbly. Maybe you don't feel like you've fixed on the gold as much. It doesn't feel as stable and secure where you're aiming, but that's the best way to shoot recurve. So now I've got that out of the way, let's start with the aiming. So when it comes to aiming, first things first, both eyes open, stare at the target and not at the sight. So this is a common mistake. People will look at the sight and make the sight focused and the target blurry, but you want the opposite. You want to stare at the target and make that focused and the sight will be blurry. And that's what you want. Both eyes open. As you can see here from these pictures of international archers, 99% of archers shoot with both eyes open. It's the way to go. So if you can't because of eye dominance, then maybe you can close one of your eyes. But as much as you can, try and shoot with both eyes open. Now, the second thing is, now that you know how to aim and look at the target, imagine you're looking at the gold, you're focused on there and the sight is blurry. How stable should your aim be? It doesn't matter if it's floating around a little bit, and this is what we call your aiming float or sight float, whatever. It doesn't matter, and it's good if your sight is moving around. So what you don't want to do is try and fix your sight perfectly on the middle, and this is probably the most common mistake with recurve archers, myself included. Back in the day, I'd try and fixate far too much on the aim. So allow the sight to loosely move. It's much better to have a relaxed, loose moving sight, maybe within the red, than a super stable, aggressive, really fixed sight on the gold. But when you release, you're going to jump one way. So allow your sight to float. Now, the next point when it comes to aiming is string picture. This is what we call the slight blurry image of the string against your vision. So it doesn't matter where you place this. You can have a number of options. Some people place the string picture and you can think of this as like a rear sight in a gun. This string picture affects your left and right grouping of your arrows. So you can place this. Some people place it just to the right of the sight pin like this. Some people place it slightly on the left edge of the riser. Some people place it on the middle of the riser. Some people might even place it on the right edge of the riser. The position doesn't matter. What's extremely important is that on every single shot, the position is the same. That's key. So personally for me, I put the string on the middle of the riser and then keep it there on every shot. Because if you don't, then you're gonna have big left and right variations. On this point, when you're expanding through the clicker, when you're pulling through and about to release, the string picture must maintain stable and not go left or right and move one way or the other, because obviously that will give you the left and right arrows as well. Now, onto the raising the bow and when to actually aim. Don't aim until at least setup position. It's very common. Someone will come up, try and aim here, and then draw the bow, and that way they've compromised how they're going to draw the bow and tried to get the aim early, but what's going to happen when they draw the bow is the aim's going to move anyway. So don't try and aim until you've come up, aligned your shoulders, and got to set up there. So aiming at the very earliest occurs at setup, and at setup, you want the sight slightly high and right. So you can see that here, maybe high and right blue, maybe 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock blue, maybe even black. It depends on the archer, but what that means is just as you come from setup in here, as you then lower into anchor, you can just slightly lower the sight onto your aiming point on the gold. So at setup, that's you just get a very, very rough aim. You're not deliberately fixing it anywhere. You're just aware of where it is, slightly high right, and then lower onto the gold as you come into anchor. In terms of the string picture, it doesn't need to be set at the start, the same as the aiming. If you try and get your string picture, say for example, in line with the riser in my example, if you try and get that right from the start, then you're going to end up drawing like this. So actually at the start, the string picture is quite right, and that's okay. And then as you lift and draw, then the string picture will come in slightly, and that's what you want to do. Now, a word on the release and aiming through the release. What you want to do is make sure you're directing the sight into your aiming spot until well beyond your release and until the arrow has hit the target. So this will ensure that your direction is good and effectively the sight is not jumping one way or the other as you release the shot. So when you're shooting, you just make sure that you're still directing the bow into the target, almost pushing the sight pin into the gold on the release. You don't want to do this during your expansion. You don't want to be like super pushing during your expansion for this. It's more of during the follow through, continuing that direction into the target. That's really, really key to maintain your aim and maintain that movement that I said is so important for recurve archery. Now, a word on eye focus, similar to what I mentioned about the aiming and directing the sight into the gold. You must maintain your eye focus on your aiming spot until the arrow has definitely landed on the target. So you don't want to divert your eye focus at all. That's a really key point there as well. Now, two other things I want to cover. The float of the sight that I mentioned before. What is an acceptable float? So basically, an acceptable float is whatever you can get with your movement still happening the right way. So if you're moving through the shot and you're drawing and you're expanding and you do the right shot, but your movement is very wobbly, that's fine. Your body over time will learn how to stabilize that, because naturally you can see the sight, you can see the target, your brain does want to aim it. It will learn how to do that. So just focus on the movement. And if you're wanting like a specific example, if you shoot, for example, 30 meters and your sight is floating around the red, but you do good shots, pretty much all of them will be in the gold, maybe even in the 10. If you fix the aim completely on the 10, but your shots are very static and tense because you're aiming too much, the arrow is going to be everywhere. So the float is less important. Some nice float is good. Get comfortable with the movement, and this is something compound archers do as well. Get comfortable with that movement, focus on your movement in the shot, and that's what you want to do there. So a word on sight pins. Try as many as you can, and if you feel like you're over aiming a little bit, try an open ring. It's really, really helpful, and because you won't have the dot, it can help you focus less on the aiming, focus more on your movement. So definitely worth giving that a try. So finally, one thing that's really good to do is to learn the sight path as you're drawing the bow, and do this with a light bow. So practice raising your bow, coming up over the slight right edge of the target, as you can see in this diagram, and then coming down to the top right setup position I mentioned before, and then slightly lowering as you come down to anchor. Practice doing that path with a light bow, and then it means when you shoot with your main bow, you don't have to worry so much about the path because you've learnt the movement, and then you can focus more on the movement that you're doing with your draw side and all that kind of stuff. So really, really important to do that, and a great way to learn the path without getting too stuck on where the sight is and worrying about that. So thank you for watching. If you haven't already, be sure to tap that like button down below, and also subscribe to the channel. I post here pretty much every week in terms of new videos, so make sure to keep up to date with that. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.